Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, let us discuss about banking of roads. Students, in this video, we will discuss about banking of roads. What is banking of roads? Banking of roads. We have different types of roads. One is a horizontal road, another is a inclined road, like this inclined slopy road. This is called banking of roads, banked roads. And we have also, in terms of horizontal and curved road, this is horizontal and curved. This is a horizontal road. This is a banked road. This is a horizontal curved road. And this is a banked curve road. This is the angle. With respect to which this road is raised, this road is raised with respect to angle theta. This is banked curve road. Now, banking of road means this horizontal road and this road, the difference is that this part is raised up, keeping this part same. That means this is the horizontal one, this part is raised up. This is called banking of roads. So banking of road means raising the is called banking of road. Raising the outer part of the road with respect to the inner part is called banking of road. Okay. Now, we will also discuss the angle of banking. Angle of banking. It is the angle the road is raised with respect to the horizontal. The angle through which the road is raised with respect to horizontal is called as angle of banking. Now, if I show you the diagram, let us say this is the diagram theta, and this diagram theta, this is called angle of banking. This is angle of banking. So this road, which is like this, suppose, is raised with such angle. This is the road. This is the road. and this is the vehicle that has to move, and this is the inclined curve road. I have the inclined and the banked road, angle of banking. Now we have to find the expression for shape speed in a horizontal curved road. Expression for shape speed in a horizontal curved road. Expression for shape speed in a horizontal curved road. So horizontal curved road we'll consider. We have a curved road but horizontal, so this is no banking, this is just a flat surface, but there is a turn in the flat surface. So when you enter this path, suppose the vehicle is entering this path, with a velocity, certain velocity v, then our aim is to find the maximum shape speed. That means this is, suppose the expression gives you some number, then the vehicle has to move with maximum of that speed. More than that it will skid. So in this horizontal curved road we'll write the, because as long as it is in this circular track, there is centripetal force needed, and the necessary centripetal force is provided because the vehicle is which part is in contact with the ground? It is the tires. So the tires, they have frictions with the surface. So while taking a turn, if it is not skidding, that means it is prevented by your frictional forces. The frictional force will be in what direction? This is frictional force. So F stands for force of friction. If I draw the free body diagram, and I'm just talking skidding into considerations, not toppling, because in that case we have to take the torque, but I'm just considering simple case, that is when it is only skidding or not skidding condition. The weight, if mass of the vehicle is M, then it is mg is the weight due to gravity, and the normal reaction obviously will be in the upward direction, and then these normal reaction N and mg will balance out. They will balance out, they will cancel out. So the vehicle is subjected to basically three forces, N, Mg, and then your frictional force. So the frictional force should provide a necessary centripetal force required for a circular motion. So F, that is frictional force, this provides necessary centripetal force for circular motion. And what is centripetal force? That we have last time discussed, and the centripetal force was mb square by r. So for circular motion, centripetal force is required, and that is provided by this frictional force, that is mv square by r part, that is the centripetal force is provided by force of friction. And if the force of friction is sufficient, then it will not skip. If the frictional force is less than what is required for circular motion, then it will skip. So if force of friction should be equal to mv square by r, or it should be more than that, then also is okay. What is required, it should be more than that also is possible, is okay, greater than or equal to this. Or I'll write that this is mv square upon r should be less than or equal to frictional force. Mv square over r is less than or equal to what is the force of friction, that is mu s into n. And this is mu s into n is m into g, that we wrote that the normal reaction will balance the weight, n equals to mg. So that means mv square by r for no skidding, these are the condition for no skidding. Mv square by r should be less than equal to mu s m into g, where m will cancel out, and v square should be less than equal to mu s gr, and v should be less than equal to under root of mu r g, or you can write mu s, no problem with that. So this is the velocity corresponding to which there is no skidding. This means that if you are negotiating the curve of certain radius r with v less than this value, then it will not skid, or maximum you can have this one. So v maximum set speed is when it is equal to mu s r g under root. If the speed of the vehicle is greater than this one, it will skid. So this is the maximum safe speed. Maximum safe speed. This is the maximum safe speed of the vehicle. So this is the final expression, that it is under root mu r g. And two things you have to remember. That will write here, note, you have to make note of this, that this V max for our safe speed is independent of the mass of the vehicle. M stands for the mass of the vehicle. V max is dependent on the root of r, root of g, and the coefficient of friction. So depending on this, we will have a few numericals, that the maximum velocity is proportional to the square root of the radius. That means if directly proportional in one way, that is if r increases, if you are moving in a greater radius, v max will also increase. That means if you are negotiating a curve of greater radius, then the speed can also increase. The safe speed can also be increased. If mu is less, then that means there is less friction, then you have to move slowly. The v should decrease because this decreases. Independent of mass of the vehicle means that for a given truck of a certain radius, the safe speed is same for all the types of vehicles, whether two-wheeler, three-wheeler, four-wheeler, any wheelers, and whatever may be the masses of that vehicle, whatever may be the masses of that vehicle, heavier vehicles or lighter vehicles. So this is what you have to remember. And next video we'll discuss something else. For this video, for watching this video, thank you very much.